empire.
You know, it's like a lot of these niggas get behind the microphone and they talk this street shit, you know what I'm saying? And they not telling the whole fucking story about this street shit, though. They fucking these young niggas up. They fucking these young nigga heads up. They got niggas thinking this shit peaches and cream, which in real life, this shit ain't peaches and cream. You know what I'm saying? It's like they glorifying the certain parts about this shit, but they not telling the whole fucking story about this shit. There's ups and downs to this shit. You know what I'm talking about? It's like niggas shed tears in this shit, blood in this shit. You know what I'm talking about? So that's why I named my shit High Class Street Music. I give niggas the whole motherfucking story on this shit. Niggas turn nothing into something. Some niggas don't make it out. A couple of us do, but most of us don't. You smell me?
High Class Street. High Class Street.
I came from nothing. I come from the gutter. I'm from a city where niggas hate to see you blow up and become a big nigga. They don't want to see you ride. They see you got your own money and you doing too much and your dreams too big. They get scared of you. Shit crazy, but it's true. I think they scared of me.
South Memphis, South Memphis, South Memphis, South Memphis, South Memphis, South Memphis. Hey, nigga, that where I'm from, where everybody drug dealing. South Memphis, South Memphis. South Memphis, South Memphis, South Memphis.
Yeah.
All my niggas counting dirty money and mud sipping. South Memphis, South Memphis, South Memphis, South Memphis, South Memphis, South Memphis.
We in the middle of motherfucking South Memphis. This is spot the motherfucking that raised me. You know what I'm saying? That motherfucking where I come from.
Memphis is just a gutter. You know what I'm saying? It's like it's grimy. Like, you know, everybody say that about their shit, but like, you come to Memphis like you really see it. You ain't gotta wait around, no see it, no nothing. Uh-huh. You go to the hood, you hit a couple of corners, like you feel like, man, I'm watching bulls in the hood.
Young Dolph is a young nigga from South Memphis. He grew up with basically nothing. You know what I'm saying? Came from nothing. I got two brothers, two sisters. I was born in Chicago, raised in Memphis. My grandma brought me down here in Memphis before I even started elementary and kindergarten. I was like, two, three years old when I came to Memphis. You know what I'm saying? So all out school, going to goddamn elementary, middle school, high school. I was always back and forth to Chicago. That's where my mama's whole side of her family from. You got the young nigga from the hood, you know what I'm saying? The gutter ain't got shit. Mom and dad in the streets ain't got shit. Grandmama raised me.
Like, I was just raised up hard, like, ain't no friends, you ain't got no friends. Don't call everybody your friend. Get you some money, take care of your business, responsibility, no playtime. Like, that's just how it raised.
Yeah.
Grandma was hard on me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But, like, that's what made me.
Everybody call me Dolph, you know what I'm saying? But my real name, Adolph, like, you know,
okay.
You feel what I'm saying? And I'm a junior, my dad, Adolph, so everybody just call me Lil Dolph. So, shit, it just is what it is. Like, even as I get old, I'm still gonna be a little dog to everybody. But my daddy,
I respect that 100%.
So, it ain't nothing fairy tale or make believe about me. You feel what I'm saying? Like, it just is what it is.
I moved my mom and dad out the hood, like, I don't know how long ago. You know what I'm saying? Like, before I was doing all this music. Man, tell me why my hood, every time I pull up in the hood, my dad in the hood. Why you in the hood for?
Yeah.
I guess I'm just like him, you know what I'm saying? Just like me. When I get out the road, come from Indiana, come from here, New York, mm-hmm. LA, Vegas, wherever. I get to the house, one pull up. It's just something about the hood.
Dolph, you were saying that before you were even doing music, you were able to move your parents out the hood. What were you doing before?
I was in the streets.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I was in the streets, hustling, young.
Seeing them back and forth, goddamn, from Memphis, not having shit in my environment there, to goddamn go to Chicago and then go to them. You know what I'm saying? So, bam. Instantly, yeah, I took it, goddamn, jumped in the streets.
know what I'm saying, fucking with goddamn some of everything, you know what I'm saying, and now I just turned everything into a music shit. I jumped out of the streets and jumped into the music shit.
See, I done been through so much that really, like a lot of stuff that made me start rapping, you feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And like I done been in so many situations, like with death, with just being in the streets, with personal stuff, that period, you feel what I'm saying? That'll make me to just like, I need you to put this on wax, you know what I'm saying? Before you hear
it. A lot of people, they got the money to put behind it for their music. They slacking on the music, the quasi like music. Or they got good music, but they slacking on the paperwork. You feel what I'm saying? On the check, you feel what I'm saying? But me, it just did. I'm all the way around the board, just going in on everything.
So it's all about staying focused and do whatever gonna work for you. You feel me? Like it, like it ain't gonna come to you overnight. It ain't gonna fall out the sky. It ain't gonna fall in your hand, get in the bed with you, know nothing. You gotta go get it.
You know what I'm saying? Excuses for the week. You feel me? I come from nothing. I come from the gutter. I come from the struggle. You know what I'm saying? All this shit nigga doing, all this shit nigga did, I built this shit on my own.
Everything I got, bitch, I got it on my own. Everybody keep asking what's up with me and yo got it.
What? Fuck all that, let's talk about that new Porsche I'm riding.
They can't do nothing but compare the both of us from Memphis. On top of that, people know the background of Memphis, the history of Memphis. Like, Memphis artists don't get along.
Is it in any situation, or y'all good?
It ain't no situation. Memphis too small. If it was a situation, everybody would know about it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just, my thing is, I don't want to be, it ain't no comparison. You know what I'm saying?
True.
Like me, like I'm in the streets, we run the streets, you know what I'm saying? Yo gotta tell you himself.
Yeah.
Feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like, man, I don't wanna it like it just is what it is. I don't wanna talk about yo gotta. Let's talk about this new whip on rad. Let's
That's
talk
right.
about all this paper on
getting. Right.
You feel what I'm saying? Like straight up, you know what I'm saying? Like
yeah.
I ain't just an artist, I'm a CEO. You know what I'm saying? I'm a businessman. You know what I'm saying? I'm a provider. You feel what I'm saying?
Preach.
Like, I take care of a lot of people, so you know what I'm saying? Like I'm in my own lane. I'm in my own category.
I've been doing this, man, on my own since day one.
Day one.
You know what I'm saying? Since day one, like, everybody, a lot of folks, a lot of people, everybody almost done came to me with different situations, like, man, let me help you with this and do this and do that. But me and my position, like, I got too much of my own money tied in this and too much of my own time in it. Like, I got too much invested in it. You feel what I'm saying? So, like, say, like, guy that wanted me to do the, like, man, come on, bro, let's do CMG paper route. It's cool. I'm knocking for that. If I was him, I would have came to me like that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But only thing was going to happen behind it was people like, oh, he popped off because of God. You
yeah.
feel what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Which I can't do that because I got too much of my own time and money investing. You feel what I'm saying? So, like I said, like.
And I know God, you know, back that because he did the same thing.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I was saying. Like, people that done been through this, they know exactly what I'm doing right now.
Yeah.
So they can't do nothing but respect it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it take a lot of hard work to get to where you like where I'm at right now, do what I'm doing.
I'm jumping this shit like 08.
What?
You know what I'm saying? Like 08. Jumping this shit. Put my foot on the gas and ain't let up on that shit ever since. You know what I'm saying?
The difference between me and a lot of artists, I ain't scared to invest in myself. You ain't gonna get far worrying about what this man doing, what that man doing, that man doing, that man doing. You can't let no nigga tell you, man, you need to make some music like this. You need to get some beats from that nigga or some beats from that nigga. Fuck all that, man. You focus on yourself, your campaign, and your nigga who you fuck. Like my first tape, Paper Route campaign. You know what I'm saying? No features, no nothing. You know what I'm saying? Just straight
rock. Yeah. It was like a fun tape. Like, I was just joking, just playing around my boy. Now they like, man, you need proud of the tape she was going to do. I'm like, man, you tripping.
Yeah.
And I did it. But the reaction I got from it, like, man, nah. I think I need to do this for real. So 2010, 2011 is when I went all the way in, head first.
That's when I went. Holler at DJ Screen. You know what I'm saying? Went fuck with 2 Chainz and 8-Ball. Drummer Boy put together a real motherfucking CD for Welcome to Dolph World. They were the tape. They got them set my shit on fire, like just turned the whole city up.
I'm on my 7th blunt and I'm on my 4th cup. y'all was born Mr. D.
Yeah.
Yeah, and my sister Sweetie, I bet you. I showed you that your bitch are free.
Like a lot of people think that was my first mixtape, but it was one mixtape before that. Went down there, got on the screen. Had 2 Chainz on there.
Like 2 Chainz, that's the first artist that I had worked with when I first like made up my mind and started doing music. You know what I'm saying? Like this is my dog called Tick. You know what I'm saying? Like this is like my big brother. You know what I'm saying? Like I seen him work, I seen him go hard, I seen him get here.
My boy been, he just been 1,000 out since day one.
Let's get to it. Flavor extra stupid. Y'all for young nigga, plugger old Jewish. Money to the ceiling. God is my witness. I've been shitting on rappers, and guess what? I'm still shitting.
Drop Welcome to Dolph World. They booked me my first show, dog. Got 5 bands for this shit. How many niggas you know? Your first show getting booked in your city, nigga. You get 5 bands for this shit. After Dolph World, do high class street music. Shout out my nigga Holiday. He did that one.
You know what I'm saying? Gooch on there. A lot of, know what I'm saying, different motherfuckers on there. You know what I'm saying? I'm fucking with Drummer.
What Drummer? My nigga Gucci. We got Gucci and Lil Rock. We got Young Dolph and Lil Rock.
You know what I'm saying? Gucci one of the first artists to show Young Dolph love. You know what I'm saying? Not sleep there. You feel what I'm saying? So I can't do nothing but rock with Gucci. You know what I'm saying? I mess with him. You know what I'm saying? Like, how can you know what I'm saying? Like, come on, that's Gucci. I met him. But I ain't never been signed with Gucci. You know what I'm saying?
Niggas gotta understand why I fuck with him. He wasn't fucked up about a nigga like shit. Yeah, Dolph, this nigga, he's gonna be, he, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of niggas that fear your come up. You know what I'm saying? I ain't get that vibe, you know what I'm saying? So any nigga that I see respect me or rocking with me, dog, you know what I'm saying? They wanna see a nigga have something, shit, I can't do shit. Why not fuck with
him? Gucci Scooter, they cool. You know what I'm saying? I fuck with them, you know what I'm saying? It's just like, I fuck with a lot of motherfuckers in the rap game. You feel what I'm saying? It's just shit. They just happen to be the ones that I got more music with. You know what I'm saying? Like, they take, they fuck with me because of the kind of nigga I am. You feel what I'm saying? They street niggas. I know that. But guess what? I'm a street nigga. They know that. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I come to Atlanta, shit, you know. I'm rock and roll. I got my own squad. I got my own cake. Like everybody first time meet me, it was somewhere and they seen me spending money. That's like everybody in Memphis, everybody in Atlanta, everybody like shit. I fuck with him. He putting out his own shit. He down here, he popping balls. He down here, he shopping. This nigga, he down here, he spending money. Well, everybody bumping to me spending money. You feel what I'm saying? Like even Gorillaz, I remember the last time seeing Gorillaz up. He was like, shit, I mean, I don't know who the fuck was in the room with him. He was like, my first time bumping to this nigga, he was in the goddamn lot trying to get a coupe. You feel what I'm saying? I ain't never look at or think of it like that, but shit, that was the truth. You know what I'm saying? It was the under the guard truth.
Dolph down there in Houston, Texas, getting his stupid ass brightening from TV Johnny.
Johnny down at the Super Bowl, he sent me down here to my guy, he taking care of me.
For real, Bobby. We call him For Real, Bobby. Tell him what's going on, Bobby. What that is right there?
It's a bright thing.
What kind of bright thing?
Good bright thing watch you got.
What kind of
news
you got? What you got to pay look like
this? This one, at least 30,000. At least 30,000. Anytime.
I'm in the L, my nigga. I don't see shit. Yeah. All these Franklins on the floor making me seasick. Uncle OG, yeah, that's who I.
So, my music, I make it high class street music. I don't just talk about one side of the street, I talk about the whole game. You feel what I'm saying? The ups, the downs, the politics, the everything. You feel what I'm saying? So, it's just real music. You feel what I'm saying? So, it's this shit everybody can relate to.
I got this shit on lock. You see what I'm saying? Shit, all you gotta do is extra streets, they gonna let you know. Like, real talk, you know what I'm saying? Only nigga out here got them get. 15 bands right here in this motherfucking city. In Memphis, I'm the only nigga that gonna get 15 bands to perform in this city besides Yo Gotti and Juicy J. It's just like that. You know what I'm saying?
Like the streets love me, literally. You know what I'm saying? Like you see these shows, you see how these people respond to these songs. It's like I'm in a pulpit preaching or something. You feel what I'm saying? Like they get the waving and shouting and like I ain't gotta break the, they drop the beat and just I can just put my hand behind my back like they sing the word for word.
What?
Like I got the streets on lock, that's what I do.
Let's go! I don't fuck with these niggas.
right, man. You motherfucking right, couldn't get it from my mama, so I got it off the block. Been watching my whole life, but I ain't never watched the crowd. 9 years old, I seen the nigga get shot.
Damn.
Addicted to hustling, I can't stop.
Artists they can come out of Memphis and they whole city like on they back, like you, your whole city like they love it. You feel what I'm saying? Like my city they love, like everywhere I go, anywhere I go. Almost every Memphis artist that you see, like they be in the streets. You know what I'm saying? And it be certain shit that like have them fucked up when it's their time to cross over, become big, like some fuck them up. You feel what I'm saying? Whether they go to jail or like anything, like it shit just, it like it's a curse. You know what I'm saying? Like it's janky. You feel what I'm saying?
I ain't time, bro. That shit sad. You know what I'm saying? Cause what's meant to happen, you can't stop that shit.
Huh. Hey, bro. Huh. I love you, bro. You hear me? I've been on YouTube looking at you everything, bro.
Hey,
you real ass
shit.
Nigga, man. Keep going to kill these niggas.
Hey, that
new Young Dolph, I think I'm sprung.
That motherfucking new city, bro.
Real talk, man. M-Town niggas, man. M-Town. Real
M-Town shit. I do this shit with y'all, bro.
I just feel like I got to keep my fans weak. You know what I'm saying? I just got to do this.
Started counting too much money and started drugging hard. Swear to God, it feel like it's a curse on me and my boys. My partner fell asleep, hit the pole and my partner died. Couple months later, I fell asleep driving to the shack. Final destination, God, this can't be my last ride. 6 years later, we flipped over again and we still alive.
We here.
Blessed.
So much shit fucking with accidents and cars and deaths and almost dying and shit, man, shit crazy. You know what I'm saying? Like, niggas don't realize my whole fucking background, like my shit, I'm just different from a lot of motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's a reason for me being in the situation that I'm in right now.
Like, I'm giving niggas ins and outs, the good shit, bad shit, real life shit, realistic shit. None of the fairy tale shit. You know what I'm saying? No make believe shit, my man.
I'm a trap rapper. I'm not just a trap rapper, a street rapper, but like I touch on the basis of all the rappers, the trap rappers, not touch. You feel what I'm saying? Like, really, this is what's going on in the trap. Not just the spending the money and having the money, the balling and all this. It's like the stress and come along with it. When you get money, you get so much money, you might have six figures over here, but you got so much stress on you, though, about getting this six figures. You feel what I'm saying? So that's what it's about, dog. Sound me for Kingpin. You know, only Kingpin go through them type of situations.
I drop
High Class Street Music 2, Hustlers Paradise, hosted by my nigga Bigger Rank. Salute the OG Bigger Rank. You smell me?
This motherfucking mixtape right here is not for fake niggas. It's not for snitches. It's not for pussy niggas. I'm about to introduce y'all to one of the realest niggas doing it right now. I want you to step to the motherfucking microphone. I talk to my niggas. I'm about to separate the real from the fake. Bigger Rank in the great. My nigga Dolph. 250 turn this shit up.
Pull up on me bumping Marilyn Manson.
The vibe was just perfect, man. We put a mixtape together, one of the hardest mixtapes. The mixtape I still listen to today. My motivation when I'm working out this shit. We put that together, man, and I've been watching his growth and watch how he flex. He's just so humble and he's so patient. I knew this day was gonna come when he was gonna be like knocking at the door. See, a lot of people get, you know, a little work here, a little work there, you know, drop a mixtape, be a book of it, but this nigga put in work. Everywhere he go, man, he never did a bad show. He take pictures with everybody, man. He's just a humble ass street nigga.
Dropped this Hustler Paradise, I was going through some shit. that I ain't never went through in my life. Like, it took Bigger Ranking and it took my dog DJ Rocksteady. I'm like, bro, they were like, what you waiting on? Like, man, you got to drop a tape, nigga. You got these folks juiced up. You got to keep this shit going. You know what I'm saying? But I was on some personal shit that was going on in the streets. I really wasn't too much giving a damn about the music. So I had to snap out of that shit. And shit went crazy. Feel what I'm saying? So after that, I dropped it, A Time to Kill. And getting the angle right, man. Time to Kill. This shit, that motherfucker had an A plus on it. Had all kind of shit on it. Like, all this shit classic. I ain't never dropped no tape that was bullshit or that wasn't a classic. After that, Time to Kill, I came with Blue Magic. Shout out my dog Scream again. You know what I'm saying? Blue Magic, that shit was like thousand. Still don't keep up with the time. According to the streets, it's my motherfucking time. Out of my music, it make you want to go get your money up, take care of your folks, you know what I'm saying, your taste bud get a little more expensive, all that, you feel what I'm saying?
Show out the young nigga, man, it's other shit to do, you know what I'm saying, nigga ain't gotta hang in the hood, nigga ain't gotta stay in the hood, just cause a nigga from the hood, that don't mean a nigga gotta stay in the hood forever. For real. Look at this shit. What's up?
He has a dollar. What's up?
Give me some
of that money. Give me a dollar.
Cash out with me.
Cash out with
you. Tell these folks, we out. I got something just for y'all.
I'm from Cash.
Hold on. Hey, go on. You good. You got yours.
Hey, I ain't getting mine.
Let me roll for the police come through here. Come on.
Huh?
I ain't got time for him.
Oh, yeah.
I'm glad I had these motherfucking stack of fives on me again.
Hell yeah, man. You know what I'm saying?
When I was a young nigga, dog, I used to wish goddamn niggas we had niggas like that, you know what I'm saying? Just come through a nigga hood, nigga, in a nigga's family, you know what I'm saying? That nigga just on some real shit, some positive shit. You feel what I'm saying? These young niggas, they looking up to me. Because I tell these young niggas, hey man, go to school. Stay in school, go graduate. Do your motherfucking work. Listen to your mom, you know what I'm saying? Don't be hard-headed and all that shit, you know what I'm saying? I show these young niggas the shit, go get you a check.
I just do this thing called A Plus Day. Like A Plus Day, like my first one of my first songs that like really broke me like national.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? So like everybody know me, like this it's like my brand, A Plus. Everybody know Memphis. Like you ask them about Dolph, they're gonna automatically say, oh, you talking about Dolph, A Plus, South Memphis, Kingpin.
They know that.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So what I did was I threw a free concert for the whole city. You feel what I'm saying? Like for South Memphis, North Memphis, East Memphis, everywhere. Like you can't nobody never done this before.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Like I had the mayor out there, I had the police force was out there. They thought something was gonna happen because it ain't never been done before.
Yeah.
So the police was out there, they had their whole police force out there. The horses, everything was out there.
Wow,
when I finally pulled up and got there, what's going on?
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? Like the narcotics riding around, like everything, like so it never been done before, and they were shocked how it just went all successful and nothing happened. Then no shooting go on, no nothing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like I'm bringing it. That's what I bring to the table.
Yeah.
That's what I'm doing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like it wasn't no limitations, no nothing. Like
different races don't party together in Memphis. Like, that's how Memphis is. Like, it's cool, it's all good. It ain't just no hate thing, but it's just like, they just don't mix and go and party at the same club. You know what I'm saying? Or out of 7 days out of the week, it might be one club out of one day that might, like, different races party together. But Young Dolph had everybody out there, man, in that park.
Good for,
like,
you, man.
Young Dolph, man.
That's, you feel dope. Me?
I like that, yeah, man. I got to chill off that heavy beat.
I know, but that's good. That's love right there.
Man, so I ain't finna do nothing to take it to the next level. So I'm letting everybody see me as I go, as I keep progressing. You feel what I'm saying? Because that's what's missing, and that's what my fans want to see. You feel what I'm saying? So I'm just bringing them into my world. You feel what I'm saying? Because a lot of my fans, they feel so personal with me. They feel like I know him, or Dolph just, they feel like they know me. So what other way can I cater to them and let them really feel like, okay, y'all feel like y'all know, okay, we'll take this then. I got you. I'm going to do this just for y'all. Just for y'all.
I've been getting money a long time, man. You smell me? One thing about this shit I can say is true. It did, goddamn, more money do bring more problems. But my money make your closest nigga envy you. The money got the streets fucked up. These niggas want money, but they don't want to get out here and hustle for this shit. These niggas think this shit gonna fall out the motherfucking sky, so I don't know what the fuck these niggas think. These niggas think, goddamn, this nigga got something to give a nigga out here. I don't know what the fuck wrong with these niggas, man. They got life twisted. This shit crazy. My niggas just got sent to the Fed. His closest partner set him up. This shit go on every day in the hood, in the street. Street sound, shit crazy. It's Dolph.
Oh man, this record got so much energy, bro. You finna crank the club back up. So, see, as a DJ, the club's kind of been dumbed down.
It's the real music right here. People don't make this kind of, they don't make this kind of music right here, man. You know what I'm saying? This the real original street music. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's giving you a story. It's, you can learn from Dolph music, man.
That's true.
A lot of everybody else, they just making songs. They making fairy tale music. You put in some Dolph, man, you finna learn how to count you some money. You finna learn how to do everything, bro.
Hey, say, you taking him to class one time.
That's what I gotta do, man. Preach, that's the name of the song.
Your bitch then told her I see you around. Dog just skipped town with 200,000. Dog just pulled a 8 in a 2-liter pop. They say Dolph addicted to these streets just like his pops. Damn.